Students, let's in today talk about the disorders of alimentary canal, disorders that's pertaining to the digestive system. Now this may be the last topic of this chapter. So let us see what could be the problems associated with the digestive system. Now there could be worms, there could be infections which may cause swelling in your alimentary canals lining, there could be wounds occurring because maybe because of some bacterial or viral infections, protozoan infections, worms, and then there could be some other problems like infection in liver, infection in other parts, and that may lead to some problems. Let us take them one by one. The very first problem is the infections only, which could be because of bacteria, which could be because of viruses, which could be because of even protozoans. Protozoans like entamoeba. There could be problems like this also. So I've given certain names also, like bacteria could be Clostridium, Salmonella, which causes typhoid. Then there could be viruses like Vibrio cholerae, which causes cholera. Then the worms like tapeworm, Tinea solium, Ascaris lumbricoides. Then there are thread worms, pin worms. There are so many worms. Then they can, they'll be there in the alimentary canal and they'll be absorbing your digested food. And in turn will be releasing certain toxic material in your alimentary canal. Thus, there will be swelling and other wounds in the alimentary canal. Then there could be another problem called jaundice. Jaundice we discussed in the earlier topics also. The jaundice means it's a symptom where the blood becomes yellow. Your skin and your eyes will appear yellow. And this will be because of that the liver is either not functioning properly because there is an infection in the liver. That's called hepatitis. Because of a viral infection, hepatitis virus, or it could be because of the obstructive jaundice we talked about, or physiological jaundice. So that there could be many diseases that may lead to the symptom of jaundice. So this is, the symptoms could be the yellowing of your eyes, your skin, your nails, they turn yellow. And this is because of the bile pigments getting into your bloodstream. They diffuse into the bloodstream rather than secreting out into the alimentary canal. Then there is a problem called vomiting. Now this is the ejection of the stomach contents through the mouth, and this is a reflex action. Suppose your stomach is getting irritated, or you are having some unwanted things in your stomach, or you are overeating, so the contents will be moving out of your mouth. Again, this is because of empty peristalsis. So this is what we call as vomiting, and this is preceded by nausea. Nausea means a feeling of vomiting. Then there is a problem called diarrhea. Diarrhea means in layman's language, this could be the loose motions. So this is the abnormal frequency of the bowel movement with the increased liquidity of the stools. So bahut zyada fast aapka peristalsis ho jayega, and without absorption of water, the content will be thrown out. Then there could be opposite thing happening called constipation. Constipation means there will be irregular bowel movement, but this time the feces will be retained in the rectum for a longer time period, and this may lead to problems. Indigestion, next problem. Indigestion can be because your food is not getting digested properly. Maybe you are overeating, maybe there is a very spicy food, or maybe you are not requiring and you are eating. So there could be these many problems. Then apart from this, there could be some other problems called PEM, protein energy malnutrition. Now what is that? This could be because of a severe deficiency of protein, or maybe severe protein and energy, both deficiency in the young children. तो ये होगा छोटे बच्चों में बिल्कुल जीरो से लेके फाइव ईयर तक. तो देयर आर टू टाइप अगेन, इट कुड बी मरासमस एंड इट कुड बी क्वाशियोकर. मरासमस अकर्स इन द चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम 1 to 3 ईयर्स ऑफ एज, 0 to 3 ईयर्स ऑफ एज, एंड क्वाशियोकर इन द बिट ओल्डर, 0 to 5 ईयर्स ऑफ एज. नाउ इन मरासमस व्हाट विल हैपन, इट विल बी ओनली द इट विल बी बोथ प्रोटीन एंड द एनर्जी, बोथ माल न्यूट्रिशन. Whereas in kwashiorkor, it is typically the severe protein energy, protein malnutrition. So agar protein ki sirf deficiency hai chote bachcho mein, amino acid and proteins ki, so the child will be having fat in the body, calories in the body, but proteins will be lacking. So the child will give a typical symptom of pot belly. The belly will come out. So that's a typical symptom that the child is suffering from kwashiorkor and not marasmus. In marasmus, the small children will be very thin, very lean, very weak, and you can even count the bones. That could be the condition. Now, it's not always that the deficiency will be causing the problems or there could be infections. Sometimes you overeat. So overeating may also lead to many problems. Suppose you're consuming some components of your food in extra amount. So that may also lead to some problems. Like, let's take some examples. Suppose aapki diet mein bahut zyada saturated fats hai. So this may lead to hypercholesterolemia. What does this mean? That there will be more saturated fats kya hoti hai? Jaise ghee type ki cheezein jo ki solidify ho jati hain room temperature pe. Aise wale fats agar aap zyada consume karte ho, so they have a tendency to go and deposit into your blood vessels, in your arteries, and this will be reducing the lumen of your artery, increasing the blood pressure. So that may lead to heart problems, blood pressure and other problems. So that is called hypercholesterolemia. Then there is another problem called obesity. Obesity means your body mass index will be more than 25, that we have discussed in the last lecture. So BMI, if it goes beyond 25, so that is obesity. So that leads to, the problem is that the fats, adipose tissue will be deposited all over your body, and this may adversely affect the functioning of organs. Then sometimes you have more of vitamin A in your diet, so that leads to hypervitaminosis A, and this has again some symptoms like, this is a fat soluble vitamin, so extra of this will lead to lack of appetite, losing your hairs, itching on skin and even pain in your bones. Then there could be hypervitaminosis D. So there are vitamin D, again it's a fat soluble vitamin, and suppose you're having it more in your diet, so this will be leading to deposition of calcium, because you know vitamin D helps in the metabolism of calcium. So this will be leading to more of calcium absorb and be depositing it in your soft tissues and joints. So that may lead to further problem and pain in the joints and bones. Then there could be fluorosis. Fluorosis means there could be fluorine in your diet. Fluorine aapki diet mein kahan se aayega? Suppose there is the water or the seafood that you are consuming may be having more of fluorine, or maybe you are keeping the toothpaste for long in your, when you are doing your brush, cleaning your teeth. So that may lead to dissolving of the calcium in your from your bones and your teeth, and your teeth may get mottled or may get colorless. Now there is a small topic on vitamins and minerals that may be important for your PMD. Let us discuss about that also. So vitamins, basically they are the approximate components of your food, not required in large quantity, but they will be required in your food. So they will not be providing any energy to us, but then they are very much required in the diet. And if you are having some deficiency, then that may lead to abnormal metabolic functioning. And you may have some symptoms, like if you have sometimes observed that aapke face ke upar ek white patch aa jata hai, ya gums mein se bleeding shuru ho jati hai, ya kabhi lips katne lagte hain, especially in the winters, and sometimes your bones may not be normal in shape, they may turn like a bow, and there could be like baal jhadne lagte hain, memory loss hone lagta hai, skin pe bahut dry irritation hone lagta hai. So they may be all the symptoms of vitamin deficiency. So kitne different type ke vitamins hote hain? There could be two types of vitamins on the basis how they are, either they are water soluble or fat soluble. So vitamin can be water soluble, and there are only two types of such, vitamin B and C. And there are some fat soluble ones like vitamin A, D, K and E. Now whatever are the water soluble vitamins, these vitamins will be like, suppose if you are cooking your food, so they will be evaporated. They are water soluble, so they will be evaporated, so you have to have them in your diet daily. But suppose it is fat soluble, and if you are having some fats, so unke saath sometimes suppose they will be there in your food also. Like suppose if it, you are having some yellow colored fruits like papaya or mango or maybe carrot, so then you may have vitamin A in that. So similarly vitamin E, K, they will be there in your green leafy vegetables. Vitamin D you can have in your milk and meat and liver. Cod liver oil, you know, is rich in vitamin A and D. So let us see a bit of problems that could be associated, a little amount, I'll give you. So vitamin B deficiency will lead to some problems of your nervous system, your skin irritation, that's called beriberi and pellagra. Then vitamin C leads to scurvy, this bleeding of your gums. Vitamin D deficiency leads to rickets, that bow-shaped bones, soft bones. because this helps in the absorption of calcium ions. Then vitamin A, which is fat soluble again, D and A and E. So A deficiency will lead to night blindness. The person cannot see in the after dusk. And xerophthalmia. Xera means dry, ophthalma is eyes. So this will be leading to dry eyes. Then there could be vitamin E. This is an antioxidant. Vitamin. So this, if there is deficiency of this, so it has been seen that the person may be having faster aging or tissue degeneration, and even in some research it has been provided, it has been shown that it may lead to sterility in mammals. It has been shown in some experiments. Then there is vitamin K. Now this is called anticoagulant vitamin. So if there is deficiency of vitamin K, you know, is a component of the blood clotting system, blood coagulation process. And suppose you are having you're lacking vitamin K in your diet, so your blood may not be able to clot properly. So this may lead to hemorrhage. Hemorrhage means your blood will keep on flowing if there is a small cut in your body.